Hello everyone, this is Imran Nemo and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video training, I'm going to create a pop-up banner like this one you can see on my demo site, and every time it shows up you can just disappear it, just hit this cross icon and you can just control how it behaves and it will come back again, or you can just, what should I say, configure everything. To do this project I have used this plugin pop-up maker, and now I'll just set up this pop-up plugin from the beginning. Just before I start, please don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel if you are very new to this channel, and like and share the video with your friends. Okay, let's get to be started. I'm just going to get this plugin name, and here I'm in the dashboard of my WordPress website, and from the plugin section I'm going to hit this add new menu. Here I will search for the plugin. This is the one. It is pop-up maker by WP pop-up maker, and I'm going to hit this install now button. Okay, it has been installed. Now it's time to hit this active now button. Okay, I'm just going to skip this part. Now you can see pop-up maker menu has been added on the left sidebar, and there are several sub menus: all pop-up, add pop-up, pop-up theme, subscriber, etc. We'll just look around all of the menus later. Just firstly, we should just take care of add pop-up, because our first duty is to add a pop-up before we take care of the setting sections. So I'm going to hit this add pop-up menu. First of all, as you can see, the placeholder text says pop-up name. So here goes the pop-up name, and pop-up title is optional, and the pop-up name is required. And as any WordPress blog post or creating any page, you can see the text editor and some setting options here. Okay, and these are just only available in the extra theme, not included of this plugin. And here is on reset count. Okay, so first of all I'm just going to name it my first pop-up. Okay, it's required, and you can just make any subtitle here, but I'll do it later. Okay, you can add a text, image or video here, but I'm just going to add an image like this. Okay, so I'm going to hit this add media, and already I have added this image, and I'm going to take the size of this image is what should I say, large. Okay, and insert into the post. As you can see, width is 1024 pixel, and what should I say, just look around this pop-up setting area trigger. I will have to work here. It is required part, this part trigger, when just actually this pop-up show up here. Just you can take different types of trigger. It will show up when your website page is loaded, like you can see, or you will get any button or image or text link, someone will click and it will pop up. Okay, but I'll just show the either ways, and I'm going to add a new trigger, and in the trigger I'm just going to select it to auto open. As you can see, it opens, as you can see, it opens automatically. So I'm just going to choose two options: click open and open autoplay. If you set to click open, then you will have to put some text or something else like any button, and the visitor will click and it will open up. Okay, just I'm going to select auto open, and would like to set a cookie also, but for this time being I'm not going to use cookie. I will come back again and set cookie later. Okay, I'm just going to add this. And delay, how long will it delay after the page is fully loaded? I'll just choose this default value. Okay, I'm just going to hit this new. It's cool. And targeting, as I said earlier, I will take care of this new cookie part later. It's the finishing part. Okay, and targeting. Do you want to disable this pop-up on the mobile screen or tablet screen? If you need to do this, just you can check this box, and then what will happen? It will disappear or it won't pop up on the mobile device screen, okay, or in the tablet device screen. Let's take care of display. First of all, appearance. It has some appearance default preset, and I'm just going to remind you that you can also manage or edit the pop-up themes also. I'll talk about this later of this video. For this time being, I'm just going to choose this light box for theme and take care of size. The image, what percentage of the image size will this pop-up take? I'll just take care of large, 80%. And animation, what type of animation do you want? Fade, fade in, fade and slide, none, fade, whatever. Okay, and animation speed you can also manage from here. And the position, where will the pop-up shows? That's like you can see it is showed on the top, but you can do this to just top center. It is top center, but you can make it to middle left, middle center also best, or top center. As you can see, it is top center. And distance from the top, the distance from the top, okay, you can just make it 100 pixel is not bad. Keep it default. Position from trigger, okay, fixed positioning, you can do this. And let's see the advanced part. It will disable the overlay and stackable. If you check this stackable, and it will help other pop-ups to be remain open, okay. Let's take care of this advanced section. If you check this box, then it will disable overlay, and if you just check this box, then it will enable other pop-ups to remain open. Actually, these things are not so difficult. You just read and check and uncheck, and every time you just experiment it, so it won't damage any data of your site, okay. So, and last part is close. How will you close? Okay, button, just like this button, or close text, any text, close button display, okay. And alternate method, click overlay to close. You can, or should I say, click this overlay to close, okay, or here just press escape to close. You can press escape button, from the keyboard to close it, or press F4 to close. Just excellent features. These are available in the free version, even in the free version, okay. So I'm just going to choose this button traditional way, and what should I say, it's time to publish this pop-up. I have already published it, but okay, let's visit my site and how this pop-up react. Okay, just visit the site, and is you can see the pop-up shows up, okay. And if you want to just change the behavior, I mean the trigger of this pop-up, I mean you will click some text and it will show up. Just what should I say, just say here on this test page, I'm just going to switch to the visual mode, and as you can see a shortcode builder of this pop-up maker. Just click on here and hit on this pop-up trigger, and which pop-up do you want to add here. Just it will show up the pop-up list. I'm just going to choose this my first pop-up, and I'm going to write some text here, show the pop-up, okay, and pop-up option, any HTML tag, paragraph tag, and back to the general, and hit save, okay. As you can see, some text, show the pop-up, and update, visit the page, just hit this show the pop-up text, it shows pop-up, okay. Hit the show the pop-up text and pop-up, okay. In this way, the pop-up will show up randomly, but if you want to manage when the pop-up will display, or if you want just the pop-up will display one time the repetition. If you want to control the repetition, just come back here in the pop-up creating option and you will just have to add a new cookie to manage it. Okay, just hit this add new cookie, and when the cookie will be created, just the cookie will create it when pop-up close at, and pop-up name, what should I say, stop pop-up, just cookie name stop now. Okay, and cookie time, how long the cookie will be saved on the browser? 1 day. Update. Okay, stop now. Just come here and hit this edit button, and I'm going to add a cookie here. Stop now. Now update, and update this button. Then the cookie will be added to my browser, and once the pop-up show up, and if I hit this close button, then it won't show up again until 1 day. As you can see, it don't show up now. Okay, come back again. As you can see, I'm going to refresh the page again and again, but the pop-up don't show up because I have added a cookie, and I told that you won't show up the pop-up again and again. You just show up after 1 day or 7 day or whatever. You can just edit and change the date. But if I just, what should I say, remove the cookie from here, just I'm going to edit it and remove the cookie, what should I say, and update it. Now if I refresh my site again and again, the pop-up show up. Okay, as you can see. So this cookie is important if you just want to, what should I say, control the repeat display of a pop-up. This cookie is important because if you want to control the repeat display of a pop-up. Okay, so we could understand, firstly we just install this plugin and activated it, and we just edit a pop-up from here. But you can just check all the pop-up already we have created on, and you can add it or quick edit this pop-up from here. And you can also check the pop-up themes, what should I say, available default theme, or you can create a new theme for the pop-up. Just hit on here and you can change all the value from here. Okay, and you can also build a subscriber form for your pop-up, but I'll try to make a subscription form based pop-up in the next video using this plugin. But in this video I just showed only the image banner. Okay, image banner. And what should I say, see the setting sections, you can just manage these things. These are easy. Just messages, you can change the default messages behavior and some miscellaneous settings. Okay, you can disable pop-up caching. If you install caching plugin, you can just disable the pop-up caching, and several setting options. And asset, you can just show pop-up maker CSS, or if you don't want to show, just you can allow to load Google Fonts or disallow load Google Fonts. These are pretty simple setting sections, and that was all about this video tutorial. Hope you enjoyed the video, and if you have any issue with this video and in this training, please don't forget to let me know through the video comment box, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Thank you.